Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to The Scope.
And now, here are your hosts, Jared, Adam, and Shane.
Hello, hello, everybody. Episode 291, our March to 300.
We're going to do something special for that.
Yes, we do. We always say we'll do something special, and we don't.
We're going to do something special for 292.
Everything is special. Everything is special. It's Jared in the studio.
Hi.
Adam is MIA again.
He's on assignment.
He's on assignment, figuring stuff out, doing deep undercover, infiltrating. I don't even
He's just gonna blow in here with like a scarf, pair of Ray-Bans, and a duffel bag full of films of some sort, just like old 8mm films.
And then we'll watch. And
he's
then
gonna say, "Boss, I got the story."
He finally did it.
They're like, "Where have you been?" He's like, "I've been on assignment,
undercover, sir.
I can't tell you where I've been, but it's all here. It's all here in this bag. You just gotta look at these films. It's gonna tell the whole story." And we're like, "How do we look at?" Yeah, films.
We don't have this projector, Adam. You're
like, "I don't know. Figure it out. I gotta go."
And then poof, he's gone.
He'll run out again. He'll open the door and snow will blow in. And be like, "It's August. How did this happen?"
And you just see like the scarf fluttering through the door as it shuts. That's all you see.
It's how Adam is.
Adam, we miss you. Adam, hopefully back soon. Hope he's doing well. Living life, I think.
La Vida Loca, we call it.
Adam is living La Vida Loca. Wow, we are back. Two shows in a row, Jared.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, that's how I feel. It's amazing. It's like putting on that pair of comfortable jeans.
Double bitches.
It's back. It's on the attack.
Yeah.
And Jared and I have something very important to talk about that probably isolates and alienates half of our audience.
Okay.
It's the NFL. So by the time this show is posted, correct me if I'm wrong, Jared, the first game of the NFL season,
yes,
for all teams,
yes, except for the
Monday night game, will be completed.
It will be.
So let's talk about NFL. Let's talk about expectations. Adam's not here to talk about his Washington team, so it's going to be a heavy purple and gold focus.
Purple and gold, baby!
Vikings went 3-1 in the preseason.
Yes.
They blew the last game in a embarrassing fashion. It may mean nothing, but it still was not cool. I think we saw some flashes of goodness for the first team offense and first team defense, but nothing super exciting.
No, other than
it's
that,
worrisome.
Other than that Dalvin Cook run in week three.
They didn't show a lot, did they?
An 85-yard scamper for touchdown.
And that was just him running, right?
Yep. And then they're like, "Well, seen enough. Shut him down.
Pull him out." Kirk Cousins, I don't know if he was... Vikings quarterback, overpriced Kirk Cousins, some might say. Had a rough third game, I think, and that's usually the game where they sort of, you know, kick off the dust off the tires and figure things out. It apparently did not work that way. So disappointing. The question is, can they find momentum to go into their first home game, which is also their first game of the season, at U.S. Bank Stadium against... Hotlanta.
Yeah. As you know, they destroyed them handily. 35-12 is the final score, I believe. So that's done. That's in the books.
You feel good about it.
I don't know. I really don't know. They're favored by 3.5 points.
They're playing at home. It's hard to say. Vikings had, for all accounts, all impressions, a disappointing season last season. They were picked to go to the Super Bowl by many, to win the Super Bowl by a few as well, and the Vikings did not even make the playoffs, Jared. They went 8-7-1 with a very difficult schedule, let's be fair. But they dropped a lot of stinky drops in the toilet.
Stinky drops in the toilet.
Against Buffalo, for one.
Call those turds.
Turds. We call a stinky drop. Vikings, again, this season, difficult schedule, Jared.
Well, you know what?
But maybe it's always difficult.
You got to deal with it. You play the hand you're dealt.
You are a guy that makes no excuses about life. You make no excuses for football. Well,
what's the point? I mean, you wouldn't even make excuses, then you have another losing season. Who cares? Like, I want them to rise above. Good teams rise above.
Rise
figure out a way to win.
Rise above. So, What is your take on the Vikings this year, Jared? Do you think they're better than an 8-7-1 team?
I think they're better than an 8-7-1 team. I think they
will. They have a record better than 8-7-1.
I don't know. I mean, right now I'm feeling like they're a 9-7 team. I hate to say it. I just don't.
One more win.
I don't feel like they're enough has changed, but maybe that's. I can't get my head around this team.
How about this, Jared? Maybe the personnel hasn't changed that much. Although I just read that they have a lot of young people on this team.
Sure.
The team is not going to look the way it does today 3 months from now. It's going to look like a different team. You're going to have injuries. You're going to have people that are going to come in. You're going to have people that go out.
Yeah.
But the question is, maybe the pieces of the puzzle are there. You just need people to execute. And they did not execute properly last year. And injuries, by the way. That also was a sticky wicket. You had people that were not playing their top level game.
I mean, the biggest question, there's two big question marks.
Go ahead.
Number one is, will Kirk Cousins come to life and actually perform under the big lights? He fell apart in primetime games.
Every
and games
big
that mattered
game,
last
Jared.
Year. Sure, he had a gaudy stat line for the season, but it didn't matter. It didn't manifest in wins.
If you can't win Sunday night, if you can't win Monday night, if you can't win Thursday night, when the game is not played at either 12 o'clock or 3 o'clock, yep. What's the deal? The beef, sir?
Yeah, and you close the season with Green Bay and Chicago, which are probably going to be in the running. So
both at home? Green Bay's at home,
both
for
at
sure.
Home.
So you are set up to take the division if you put yourself in a position to do it, Jared.
Yeah.
You've just got to grab that ring.
And there are some questions on who is the receiver depth once you get past
they've got four,
Thielen and
Diggs. They've only got four receivers.
Only got four. I think they're probably waiting to see what other teams have released.
Is it Zylstra or whatever?
Zylstra?
Zylstra, they might put him on practice squad, possibly.
If he makes it through waivers.
If he makes it through waivers, they like that
sure.
kid. But they're willing to let him go.
Yeah. I mean, they let Laquan Treadwell go.
Treadwell gone, which I think...
It's fine.
It's fine. It's fine.
Yeah.
To quote your sister, it's fine.
He was targeted way more than he should have been last year because he didn't succeed in those targets most
yeah.
of the time.
He dropped big... Big, big, important plays, balls.
I think a strong spot for us is our team of running backs.
Running backs?
As long as Dalvin Cook stays healthy, and you know, we've only saw a little bit in the preseason. Yeah. For all we know, he may have ruptured his other ACL
Boom.
In game one. But he looked good, and the depth behind him looks really good.
You've got a pretty interesting core of tight ends as well, Jared.
Yes.
You could have Kyle Rudolph, Landry. Lance yep. breaking loose.
You got him. He got the other guy.
Some other dude. I don't know.
There's a whole bunch of them. There's a guy that drafts.
Did Ham make the team, Jared?
CJ Ham is on the team. Yep.
I like that. I like a guy named Ham.
Yep.
Here's the big question mark, Jared. Yep. There's two.
Okay.
One.
Defense
has to play better. Defense dropped
these
off
are your
last
own question
year.
Marks. I got my question marks.
Defense has to play better. Correct.
It does. It,
they dropped in all their stats from 2 years ago, Jared.
And it's a team that has been together and played together yeah. and is, I mean, Zim is a defensive guy. They've had great success with mm-hmm. this squad. And supposedly Mike Hughes is back and healthy.
Yeah, but he's not. He's playing limited practices still.
Sure.
So who knows
what
he's
in back,
be.
But this is a defense that should be lights out and should excel.
Absolutely.
So for them not to do that will be a big problem.
Lights out defense leads to more offense. But the Vikings, you talk about running backs, you talk about tight ends, you have to have an offensive line
yeah.
that is middle of the road. Even a middle of the road offensive line would be a improvement where I think for missed blocks, the Vikings ranked last in the league.
Well, they were a bunch of jelly beans last year.
I don't even know what that means.
It means they're squishy and you can just push them out of the way. this year,
the white jelly
hopefully
beans
they're
are
improved.
Gross
they ones. Drafted a center. They moved our center from last year to, I believe, left guard.
Has he worked on his anal sweating? Is that figured out?
I haven't
out?
Heard any fresh stories about his sweaty butt, so
okay.
I'm guessing they've addressed
they
situation.
Figured that out?
I think they've got a solution for game day. That's what matters.
They put him in Pampers, and boom.
What we can't have is we can't have him sweating over Kirk Cousins' hands and then having a slippery ball.
Yeah.
Can't have that.
There's a whole mess with that, that's right. for sure.
So you got to leverage some technology, maybe get some nanofibers going. I don't know. Maybe get some of those Duluth Trading Company armachillo underwear to
right.
keep them cool.
Maybe buy something at the Red Wing Shoe Store.
Yeah.
Bring some of that in.
Just dropping all the local references. I don't know. I think the offensive line is improved. Is it elite? Probably not.
Absolutely not, Jared. They're not
but
elite.
I'll take improved.
And they're going to be playing Cousins out of the shotgun?
Less. Yes. He doesn't do well out of the shotgun.
So they're going to... I've seen a lot of rollouts. I've seen a lot of play action in the preseason. Is that going to continue?
I don't know. Maybe.
Move him around.
I think the common wisdom on this is that the offense they ran for the bulk of last year before they fired DeFilippo was not a good fit for Kirk Cousins' skill set.
Okay.
And I hear Kevin Stefanski's offense is better suited to that, so we'll see.
I see this team like you, 9-7 probably at best right now.
Yeah.
They could prove us wrong, but I think that there's enough obstacles and enough question marks that 9-7 is where they're at. They will be a borderline wild card team. That being said, the NFC North is a weird place, Jared. You had a very strong Bears team last year, but we've seen the Bears not be able to put together strong seasons back-to-back. We've seen the Packers. We don't even know what's going on with that team.
They've got a coaching change now.
We don't know what's...
Aaron Rodgers seems like he's injured. I don't know.
And he also seems like he's an egomaniac.
Yeah, I hope that cancer eats the team from within.
Yep, that's ruining them. And then you've got the Detroit, who every year seems to improve, but yet never seems to make the playoffs. So I don't really know what to make of what's going on right now. I don't know. I think it could be a knockdown, drag-out season for all four of those teams. And you could have a team that in our division that wins the division with 10 wins.
Yeah.
Very possibly.
Yeah.
So who knows? Who knows what's going to happen?
I think we may win or lose games depending on the question mark number two that I have for the team, and that is the kicking game.
Right.
We haven't even talked about
Jared.
That.
I totally. Because it's always a given, but it cannot be a given, can
it? It's a big trauma point for the Vikings in this.
Tell us what happened and what they did with the kicking situation.
So last year they drafted a kicker in the fifth round, Daniel Carlson. That was his name. And he had a horrendous start to the season. In week two, he missed four or five field goals. Gone. Cut him. He's out. They bring in...
Where did he go to? Do you remember?
He ended up in Oakland, where I don't think he's missed a...
How did he do?
I don't think he's missed
a
kick in a game since. So
perfect Vikings karma right there.
Great. We brought in... Did we bring in Dan Bailey at that point?
I believe Bailey was the next that came in. Yep.
So he was...
He's a Cowboy kicker, right?
Former Cowboy kicker. They let him go for whatever reason. I think he was too expensive for him. We still end up paying him $2 million, which is not cheap for a kicker. He was okay.
Middle of the road,
missed some stuff here and there, and probably cost us a game or two because of that. You enter training camp this year with Dan Bailey on your roster, but you're not 100% sure that he's going to be the guy. And by all accounts, early in training camp, he was problematic.
Right.
Missing kicks. Now, you can chalk that up to them trying to figure out the long snapper situation. Once they figured out the new guy, I think he's a rookie, is going to be the guy, things seemed to stabilize there. They were also playing around with different people holding. I think they found a combination that maybe stabilized things.
Yeah. People forget it's not just the kicker always. Right. There's the hold and the hike.
Yep. The hike.
The hike.
Yes. That said, they still were unsure about the position. So after a couple games in the Ravens played, the Vikings made a move. They traded for this Norwegian-born kicker named Kari Vedvik.
Mm-hmm.
Apparently, he's got a strong leg. He can punt. He can kick. He can do everything.
He's a triple threat.
He had made 11 of 12 field goals. But in Baltimore, he wasn't going to make the team because Justin Tucker was still there. He's going to start. So he was expendable. Apparently, other teams were interested. The Vikings said, we want to get ahead of that. They made a trade, fifth round pick again. They made the trade, brought him in. This guy's going to shore up things. And all he did is proceed to miss three field goals in the preseason games, have bad punts, and give up a punt return for a touchdown. And ultimately got cut.
Yeah.
He got cut with the final cut down to 53-man roster. He did not. They burned a draft pick. And he didn't even make the team.
His dream came crashing down very quickly.
And I think they had hopes to bring him in on the practice squad. But guess what? The Jets claimed him. Jets claimed him off the waiver wire.
That's breaking news?
Yes.
Breaking
news. The Kari Vedvik era, 21 days, is over.
Oh, that's a stinger right there.
Yeah. So apparently the Jets were interested in this too, and now they get him. They were interested in the back when the Vikings traded. And now they get him without having to expend a draft pick.
Yeah.
So
Vikings look like chumps.
Vikings will open the season with the same squad that they closed the season with. That is Dan Bailey at kicker, Matt Wiley as punter. They maybe have a different holder. I don't know if Chad Beebe was holding last year, but That's where we're at.
And the one thing I can say about special teams generally in the preseason, Jared, dicey.
Yeah.
They were not good. I mean, even beyond the kicking, we're talking about coverage, that sort of thing. So,
I think we had some good returns, so
yeah, but
I feel good about that. But
anything where you got to stop the other team, it was all over the place. So.
Unless you got Matt Boone out there. He was making some good plays.
Yeah. So we'll see.
That's the reason he made the team.
You don't see everything. You don't see all the plays. You don't see all the tricks. You don't see all the plans in preseason, so things could change. But right now, you and I have question marks. We're not convinced.
Yeah.
One last question, and then we'll wrap it up. Do the Vikings win their division? Go.
I'm going to say yeah.
You're going to say yeah. I say no.
9-7? Maybe not.
I say no.
You say no.
I say no.
I'll just take this. I'll say yes.
Yeah, and we'll see how.
Sure.
Because we've been surprised.
It's not going to be a strong commanding win, though.
And the Vikings have had seasons where, you know, it's sort of with the Coach Zim, it's a back and forth season. He'll have a successful season right. And then a disappointing season. So
if the Vikings don't win the division and barely make the playoffs and don't make it to the Super Bowl or even the championship game, is Zim out?
If they don't make the playoffs, I think that
Zim's gone for sure.
I think he needs to be concerned about his job.
I think he's gone for sure. Period.
Zim, but I think that
you can't not.
I think you've got talent there where you should be able to win the division.
You can't not make the playoffs with the amount of money they've spent on Kirk Cousins. Yeah. Sorry, it's a business.
That Kirk Cousins might end up being a big mistake for them.
Yeah, could be.
But, I mean, they had to make a move.
We'll see.
All right. So, you know what else we'll see about, Jared? We've got a Nerd Roundtable coming up this episode.
Yeah,
people love the Nerd Roundtable. It's for us, it's kind of like a big, long banquet table, you know? Like, you're sitting at one end with all the candelabras, and I'm sitting at the other end, and
we just have
a waiter's walking back and forth. You're like, please pass the salt. And then he would get it and walk all the way across that beautiful mahogany floor.
Ooh, I like this.
And then you get the salt.
Is there chamber music playing?
Of course there is. What do you think? We're not savages.
Okay. That's why, a good string quartet or something can help the digestion.
I love it. I love it. Well, people are going to love this Nerd Roundtable because we are going to dip into the history of Spider-Man.
Woo!
And the modern history of Spider-Man. And it might be kind of sad.
Oh, I don't want to be sad.
Yeah. Well, we're going to break it down for everyone that wants to know. So let's take a quick break, a breath, if you will. And we'll be back with more of episode 291 of Your Scope Program.
Hello, folks. Yes, we're still doing this show. And thank you to all of our new patrons who signed up after the last show. You want to support us? Go to patreon.com/thescopeshow. You can pledge as little as $1 per episode and set a monthly cap. Cancel anytime, but you're not gonna because you're a cool person and you want us to thrive and give you more content. That's The Scope Show, patreon.com/thescopeshow for all the details. Yeah, go get it, kids.
Everybody, we're back with the Scope 291 and the Nerd Roundtable. This time around, Jared and I take a deep dive into the Marvel/Disney v. Sony battle over Spider-Man. Jared,
oh God,
this is a hurtful one. We don't like to get into this. This news bummed me out tremendously when we heard about it. But I think we need to get into the history a little bit. Back in the 90s, I would say, Marvel as a company, which was not owned by Disney at the time, was in deep financial straits. They were on the verge of bankruptcy, and they decided the best way for them to make money would be to essentially sell off portions of their characters to other movie studios, in which Marvel would eventually get a cut of the movies that were made.
But they
didn't really have control of those characters.
Nope.
So what ended up happening was that Fox got their hands on Fantastic Four and X-Men and Daredevil and some other characters. Universal got the Hulk, and they might have... Somebody had the rights to Namor in there, I think. But the big crown jewel was Sony got Spider-Man. And all of the Spider-Man characters... I would probably say that X-Men is the crown jewel or equally, but there's
a
lot of Spider-Man characters. So it would be all of his villains, I guess some of the heroes of that group, I don't know if they're...
Who else qualifies as a hero?
I don't know. I mean, like, Black Cat is sort of an anti-hero. There's a few in there that go back and forth, but essentially Spider-Man is the key. And this was all fine and dandy to help Marvel get money, but in the long run, it brought into question how they would ever... All these characters would ever be in movies together, right? This was pre-shared universe.
Oh, yeah. They didn't have any sort of hopes.
Right.
I mean, maybe they had
right.
hopes.
Marvel held on to the Avengers. I think that was always part of their game, that they wanted to get into the movie business. And the Avengers was going to be where they were going to make their money, because there's a lot of Avengers characters.
Absolutely.
But, again, they didn't have these other characters. And the only way that they could get those rights would either, A, to be to buy them back, or... If these movie studios over time did not make a proper film in a certain amount of time, the rights would just revert back to Marvel.
Right.
Which did happen for Daredevil, which Daredevil then turned
into. Well, I mean, they made a film. They made
which was garbage.
A couple films in that, but, you know, then even more time elapsed past that. Yep. And, yeah, the rights.
And the Punisher, it also happened with the Punisher.
Yeah,
they got
the
rights back with the Punisher. And I think the overall arching theme on most of these things is that, with the exception of a couple films here and there, all of these disparate movie studios made poor Marvel movies. They weren't great. They were fine. Some of them were okay. A lot of them weren't great.
The first couple of Spider-Mans were good.
Yep.
Three was terrible.
Second one was the best. First was okay.
Yeah.
Same with X-Men. The first X-Men movie was cool to see an X-Men movie, but it wasn't great. The second one was better. The third one was poor. The reboots of the Spider-Mans were fine, maybe a little bit better, but also not as great. So over time, Marvel starts making their movies. Things start looking good. Disney buys Marvel.
We're cooking with gas.
The Marvel Cinematic Universe is born. I think the people at Marvel really want to get the rights back to their characters, but they're not going to be gifted these very easily. As a matter of fact, they're not going to give the Fox and these companies are not going to give them up at all.
Well, no, they now they know they're valuable.
Right.
Now they know that Disney owned Marvel wants them back bad.
Right. So what ended up happening, for all of you who don't know, is that Disney bought Fox, so now they have the rights to X-Men and Fantastic Four. But before that, they struck a deal with Sony to co-produce.
Yeah.
Co-produce Spider-Man movies, because the second series of Spider-Man films starring Andrew Garfield didn't go over very well. They were diminishing returns, critically indifferent. So they decided, we're going to get in a little bit of that Marvel magic. They signed a deal to do two Spider-Man films, and I think it ended up being three movies in which Spider-Man could be involved in the Marvel movies.
And we've gotten five that Spider-Man has been involved in the MCU. So
then it's time to renew that contract, Jared.
Right.
In the meantime, you've got Sony getting, don't even get Jared and I started, getting very lucky with Venom, which for all intents and purposes was a whack movie. We don't know why it was popular.
We didn't like it.
A Tom Hardy performance was just weird, but wasn't notable. And it felt like every other garbage superhero movie that we'd seen before the Marvel Cinematic Universe. That's what it felt like to us. But it was a worldwide blockbuster. So Sony's getting cocky, Jared.
Sony thinks now, we know what to do now. Mm-hmm. We figured it out. You know, we went back to Marvel. We gave it back because, you know, people wanted to see Spider-Man in the MCU. That's what they really wanted to see. They wanted Spider-Man to be connected with all of the other Marvel heroes. And Kevin Feige does know what he's doing with these films. So we'll get a little bit of that. But we'll learn everything we need to learn. But now we've got it figured out. We know what to do.
So we think. We don't know the full story for sure.
We've made one additional film, live action film, that did better than we expected it to. And so now we know what we're doing.
Right.
We know what we're doing.
Oh, hubris. Isn't it beautiful, Jared? So, what ends up happening is that Marvel and, you know, that starts breaking in the press, in the trades, that Marvel and Sony are parting ways, not working together. Marvel's remained mum on this, for the most part, nothing official, but Sony releases a statement essentially saying that they're disappointed, that the problem is that Kevin Feige's too busy to do the work for Spider-Man to work with us. So we are going to go and we're going to do it ourselves. With maybe like a tiny little crack of the door open.
Okay.
But nothing concrete. And then, what was it at? Where everyone kind of got together. Was it Comic-Con? No, I don't. No, the Disney.
The D23.
D23. That was sort of the first public public comments. And Tom Holland pretty much said that he's sad, but Spider-Man will go on. And Kevin Feige was like, it was a good run.
It's so cavalier. As a fan, I hate seeing that. Because it's like, I get that it's a business,
mm-hmm.
but we thought we had gotten through.
And so here's the thing, Jared. It's not a clean break. So if Spider-Man is pulled from the Marvel Universe proper, how is this going to work? Far from this, we're going into spoiler territory, but
it's been a few months.
Spider-Man is tied directly into the Marvel Cinematic Universe, like with a bow tie at the end of Far From Home. Yeah. And he's tied into the shape-shifting Skrulls. He's tied into Nick Fury. He's tied into kind of the guy that's going to take over Stark Industries or be a part of that. I mean, Spider-Man's identity is exposed to the world. It's all tied into this big Marvel thing.
I don't know how you make.
I don't know how you do it without
a Tom Holland
over.
Spider-Man that is now no longer part of the MCU.
Right.
It's going to be a failure. It'll make some money. People will see it, but like. As fans, this is what we wanted. We wanted Spider-Man as part of the MCU, and people, for whatever reason, they don't want to talk about how Marvel movies that are not part of the MCU are not doing as well.
Right.
Because people want it all connected, even if it's not explicit, like in the film itself. People want to know that these things exist in the same universe. And for them to suddenly go, oh, we're just going to make another Spider-Man, but now it's not connected. No. That should fail.
Yeah.
That should be a disaster for them, because... As fans, this is what we wanted.
Yep.
You know, and maybe I'm overstating it. Maybe there's people out there who are just way more casual about this and don't care. They'll just be able to watch it and go, oh, okay, it's more Spider-Man. I'm fine with that.
Mm-hmm.
But I think you look at the history of these movies and you see, like, the Amazing Spider-Man series did not do as well. And you have to figure part of that is because it was not connected to the MCU.
They didn't know how to do villains. They just didn't feel like they had a complete grasp of the story.
The X-Men movies that have come out since the MCU was well established just didn't do as well. Or, I mean, part of the reason you can make the case is that they're just not good movies.
Right.
But, you know, mediocre MCU fare still does pretty well. So,
it's a head scratch.
People want the connective thread,
yep.
and they've bought into this world and this series of movies, and for them to just think that we're not going to be part of that anymore is just stupid.
The biggest losers will be the fans, number one.
Oh, absolutely.
Right behind them will be Sony, and I think Marvel can weather it. I mean, Marvel, they ended this chapter.
Marvel doesn't need Spider-Man.
The Thanos chapter. I mean, they can pretend like Far From Home didn't happen. Essentially, they can pretend like that did not happen. I mean, you have a break.
Well, they can or they can't. They don't need to pretend. They just move on.
Yeah, and they just not mentioned.
Like, there's nothing in that film everything that happened in that film can be built upon with other characters.
Sure.
That's what I mean to say. Like, you don't need to have Spider-Man, because where that film ends, he's already moved on from that storyline.
Yeah.
He was going to go into his own Spider-Man story at that point. Everything else that they've done that is relevant to the MCU can carry on and go forward.
And I'm just saying, like, the Nick Fury connection, all that stuff, they can...
Doesn't matter.
They can sort of pivot away from it. I think that Marvel will weather it okay, and especially with Marvel's slate of movies like Black Widow, Eternals, Black Panther, Guardians, Doctor Strange, Thor. None of that really deals with... You know, most of that stuff doesn't even seem like it takes place in a superhero Earth realm. You know, it's either a spy caper, or it's gods, or it's... Wakanda, which has nothing to do with Spider-Man, or Guardians 3, which is out in space.
Everything from the larger MCU that happened in Far From Home was incidental. None of it was tied explicitly to Spider-Man.
Except for Nick Fury on some sort of space station.
Whatever. I mean, that could just be. It happened relative to Spider-Man, but it could have happened with any character.
Sure.
It's not. There's nothing intrinsic to Spider-Man there.
And you don't have to ignore it. You don't have to ignore it.
You just move on from it, and you do whatever threads, you continue whatever threads you set up with other characters and other films.
Right.
Never mentioning Spider-Man again. And it's perfectly fine.
Right.
And I'm sure Disney probably knew that.
Yeah, they set it up in a way.
We're going to do this in a way. It's going to be part of Spider-Man, and we're going to include Spider-Man. But if Spider-Man goes away, we can continue just fine. Yeah. So and that's probably what's going to happen.
And Spider-Man gets hurt. Happy is gone. So Aunt May doesn't have Happy unless there's some deal that says that Favreau can be in those movies. But my guess is that he won't be there. She'll break up with him or something like that.
Doesn't matter.
Right?
It's not an important enough storyline that the deal is going to hinge on it.
Yeah, I just mean it's like it's part of that connective tissue is what I'm talking about.
It's a nice thing to have. It's not a have to have. Not like Spider-Man's swinging around with Mjolnir in his hand.
Right,
like, oh, shit, how do we get the hammer back? We need that.
So let's talk about how we think this is going to play out. Will there eventually be a deal?
There has to be. They're stupid if they don't.
Yeah. There has to be. They have to figure something
out. Now, I think one of the sticking points is that Disney wanted a larger cut of the money.
But I hear it wasn't as much as...
Wasn't the 50-50? That was a lie?
Yeah. That wasn't true.
Because it was initially like only 5%.
Yeah.
Which, okay. And I think that they've probably earned a bigger take.
Yeah.
Like,
given
you've seen the results.
Given that that opens up the door to Sony making all these other pieces of shit Spider-Man movies, maybe they should do that. Like, that's the cash cow. People will watch those movies if there's that connective tissue. I still feel like Sony and Marvel should have figured it out where every single one of those Spider-Man movies tied into the Marvel universe. Why wouldn't you just go for it and say this is going to be a long-term thing, we just bring it all together, and we figure out a way to make this work, because it's only going to bring us more money.
And Sony wanted, I believe it was reported, that they wanted Venom to be part of it, but Disney was like, we don't think so. And maybe it was just that, because that they didn't like that particular film or something, but yeah, Sony wanted Venom to be part of the MCU. And you could easily retcon that. I mean, there was nothing happening in that film that couldn't have happened in the MCU.
Right.
There was no mention of
it. I mean,
it was
in a different city. It was in San Francisco.
You know,
so
she just pretend it was a Netflix series that was connected to the MCU.
Right.
But, you know, yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what's going to happen. I hope that they figure it out. If they don't, frankly, unless this is Disney, you know, swinging big balls around, I feel like Sony is completely miscalculating what they've got. And just because they had success with Into the Spider-Verse and other stuff, their track record for making live-action Spider-Man movies has been poor. And
I mean,
how do they change that?
Venom it only made $213 million. It's not like it blew the doors off.
Yeah. Is that domestically, or is that...
That's worldwide.
That made that much?
Yeah.
That little worldwide?
I believe so.
Ooh,
I mean,
boy.
I'm looking at Box Office Mojo.
That's not great.
Sorry, that is domestic. Plus foreign is another. So worldwide is $856 million.
Which is a pretty good take.
That's pretty good. That's pretty good.
But only 200 and something in the United States is not... That's not gangbusters.
They look at the worldwide, so... But, you know, Far From Home makes, you know, $1.1 billion.
Yeah. I just think that if... When they pull the ripcord and it sort of goes into its own universe officially, I just think that it's going to be a big problem for them, for Sony. And it's disappointing.
Yeah, I mean, and part of this is us not wanting it to happen, but we've been here before. We've been here with Spider-Man not part of things and Sony just doing its own thing.
We've heard this tune before, brother.
Yeah.
We've heard it, and it's usually a pretty, pretty bad tune.
So, yeah.
It's like Ace of Base.
Yeah. I can't believe they can't work it out. I just don't understand it. Figure it out.
Well, we'll see. We will keep our sources close, Jared, and any breaking news, we will present it to our Scope listeners.
We'll break into our coverage.
We'll break in. A quick question. Marvel's upcoming slate of movies, Black Widow, Eternals, Black Panther, Guardians, Doctor Strange, Thor. Is that enough star power? Is it so anti-Avengers that it's so different that people are not going to be as excited about these films? Is it a perfectly good move, a good pivot away from the status quo into something that's has some similarities, but at the end of the day is quite different?
I think it's a good question.
That's a great question, not a good one.
Yeah, I don't... it's an interesting slate of movies. It's definitely not.
And Black Widow's the first one, too. Black Widow's the first one. It's not even a
superhero. Black Widow's the only one we're getting next year.
Really?
I think so.
Okay.
Yeah. Nothing else is currently actually in production. Eternals is getting ready to spin up, but some of these are like, they're definitely smaller films, and that's fine. I think it's okay to have, after such a big event of Avengers Infinity War and Endgame, that it's fine to ratchet things back.
Yeah.
They're putting an awful lot of effort into Disney Plus, which we will talk about in the future.
I
just don't know. I'm excited to see what they do, but I've definitely not seen a lot of like lockdown home run type movies here.
And so, where is this going?
I mean
with the kind of the Avengers saga, if you will, everything kind of fed into each other. These things are so different. You know, Black Widow is supposed to be a movie that takes place in the past. You know, Eternals is about these weird gods. Black Panther's more of a typical grounded.
Yeah.
Guardians That's of the fine. Galaxy in space. Doctor Strange is supposed to be the first horror movie. Thor is changing the script by making Natalie Portman Thor. But how do they all come together? Because these movies, is that Marvel's goal, where they're going to lead them together to, you know, phase four, where you've got a big group, where there's a new Avengers, or what is this going to be? I think that it's so out there that we just don't know, which is kind of exciting. They're trying to give us something a little different.
Yeah.
I just don't know. Individual, all these things are interesting, but
is actually coming November next year.
Okay. But I just don't see how all these fit together. I don't see it. I mean, maybe that's for the best. Yeah,
did you even mention Shang-Chi?
Oh, I forgot about that one as well. Yeah, Shang-Chi.
It's cool that we're getting
a karate movie
representation like this, but yeah, what is this all going to?
Which
is a little weird, because it's like, were we even asking this back in, 10 years ago when this was starting? We knew it was headed towards Avengers, but we didn't really know what that looked like.
Right.
So, I mean,
none of the characters in here, with the exception of Thor and Black Panther Black Panther, obviously a huge movie, but he was a tier two Marvel character for many, many, many years. There's no big names. I mean, Thor, Iron Man, Hulk, Captain America, that's your big knockers right there. And they're almost all out of this picture. Yep. So I think the verdict is out, my friend.
Well, I'm hoping Marvel Studios has the confidence that they can take these lesser known characters and develop them into characters that everyone will eventually know.
Right.
And love.
That's it.
I mean, that's kind of where we were.
And we've got to give them the benefit of the doubt, because they've done it.
We were kind of there with Iron Man and Hulk and Thor. Now, we're outliers because we read the comics. We know who these characters were. A lot of people didn't really have any idea who they were.
No.
They didn't know what a Doctor Strange was.
No.
They knew Spider-Man, but, you know.
Spider-Man, Thor was about. Spider-Man, Captain America, maybe Iron Man, maybe Thor. They knew who Hulk was. But, but two-thirds of the Avengers, they'd never heard of.
So, we'll figure it out.
It's exciting. It's a new time, but we'll have to wait till next summer to find out.
And now we've also been hearing murmurs that they're working towards A-Force. If you're not aware what A-Force is, it's the all-female Avengers team that was introduced from, it came out of the Secret Wars, did it? Or was it before
I think it was the second Secret Wars.
Right. Yeah. That's what I mean.
Yeah.
And it's so, that's word that they're building towards that. So that's why they're doing a She-Hulk series. That's why they're doing Ms. Marvel. That's why they're doing Captain Marvel will show up there.
Yep.
They're doing all of these characters that will eventually lead to there. Is that the next Avengers? I don't know. Maybe. We don't know.
And the other question, which ties into our next show, is how does the Disney Plus lineup of shows tie into the movie verse of this?
Right.
You know, because it sounds like they're really going to try to tie this stuff together in a way that's never been done, which is really exciting. But we just have to see if they can be successful doing it.
Agreed.
Wow, Jared. Well, this has been one heck of a Nerd Roundtable. I think we should end it here with our Marvel. We'll make it a Marvel-focused roundtable.
Okay.
And we don't have all the answers, but we know that we're excited about some and we're sickened by others. Sony, Marvel, Disney, figure it out.
Yeah, agreed.
Thank you very much. So take a quick break. We'll be back with coming soon on episode 291 of Your Scope. Three geeks on the internet, WSCP.
Under the Scope.
Yes, indeed, it's Under the Scope. And, of course, we've got Coming Soon. All right, here we go. Music for September 13th. Jared, one of your favorites, Charlie XCX with Charlie.
My favorite.
You love her.
Do I?
Your second favorite of all time, Goo Goo Dolls with Miracle Pill. Your third favorite, I mean, it's like it's literally listing your entire playlist. Korn, The Nothing. Puddle of Mud, Welcome to Galvania. Yikes.
What a weird group of albums.
I know. The Pixies are back with Beneath the Eyrie. We've got the Lumineers with Three. And then finally, Twin Peaks with Look Out Low. You thought that was it, Jared. Pot that baby down. Movies, September. We'll figure that vibe out. We'll figure it out. Movies for September 13th. We've got The Goldfinch, based on a acclaimed book.
Oh, was it a book?
I believe so.
Okay.
And then Hustlers.
Hustlers looked interesting.
Hustlers looks interesting. For home release on September 10th, Will Smith is back. The guy. He's everywhere.
He's the guy.
He's the genie. Sometimes he's normal skin. Sometimes he's blue.
He's really back.
Did Aladdin not look like garbage to you?
It did.
It looked like garbage.
It's not for me.
I'm surprised that's not a miss it.
Well, it might.
Hmm.
It sort of happened during the period when we weren't doing shows. And
right.
We'll have to catch it on the home release.
We will.
Oh, is that it?
That's it. Turn it off. It looked so good for a second. And for video games, the week of September 8th, we've got Borderlands 3, Grid, and if you like a little ice hockey, Jared, NHL 20.
What's Grid?
It's a, I think, I don't know. It's a game. I've heard about it.
Okay.
That's all I gotta say. But that's not it, Jared. We've got a little something called Hit It or Miss It.
Hit it or miss it. Hit of the week. Hit it or miss it. Miss of the week. Look out!
Yes, indeed. Jared's Weezer parody brings us to our Hit It or Miss It.
Weezer?
It's not Weezer. Why did I say Weezer? I was thinking Weezer, and it's actually President of the United States
there
of America.
You go.
Jeez Louise, Jared. Yeah, this is your... You really were excited about this pick, were you not? It's a home video release, September 10th,
yeah.
Stars Keanu Reeves, the guy. People
Everyone.
Love him. They
man
love
of,
this
man
guy.
Man of the year.
Have you seen...
Put him on a Time magazine cover.
Have you seen any of these films?
I've seen the first two.
Okay, so tell everybody what we're talking about.
We're talking about John Wick Chapter 3, Parabellum.
Stars...
Keanu Reeves.
Keanu Reeves.
And...
Isn't Halle Burr
his,
in
and
this?
And his guns.
Is Halle Burr in this one?
I believe Halle Berry is in this. Halle Burr, she's in this.
She's good.
Other people are in this,
A lot
this
of people.
Too.
But this is action, Jared.
This is action.
It's
this
fighting.
This is gung-fu.
Gung-fu?
Gung-fu.
And just we found out Matrix 4 on the way.
Yeah. And he's currently filming or has recently wrapped up the Bill and Ted's movie.
It's
all Keanu all the
Keanu
time.
Keanu Reeves renaissance. A Reevesassance.
This is a hit. I love the first two. I'm excited. I did not see Chapter 3. I've heard very good things about it. I believe this is the end chapter of this series of movies about assassins
right.
and their code and how Keanu thwarts that because he's got a higher code.
I've never seen one of these films. I feel like I'm missing out.
They're very violent, but if you like...
Are they bloody or is it just like chop-socky stuff?
There's some blood, but it's not... I don't think the blood is gratuitous. There's just a lot of shooting and a lot of killing.
Okay.
So,
all right. So
and I will just say that not all animals are safe. So take that for what
wow.
it
is. Well,
there's a horse. There's a horse riding in this one. There's motorcycles. It's just it looks crazy.
It sounds bananas.
It looks amazing. I hear they're doing a TV series based on the hotel, the Continental, that is featured in these films. So looking forward to it. John Wick Chapter 3 Parabellum.
Under the Scope.
Ooh. Ooh. Under the Scope, Jared.
So you say.
Clean up that cassette.
Coming over here looking at my my cassette tape of LL Cool J, Bigger and Deffer.
I'm going to take some notes on this Logitech solar keyboard.
You do that. Hey, you know what that sounds like? It sounds like an email being composed.
Here it is. This is all the emails flooding in right now.
So how do you feel about the NFL upcoming season? I don't care about like how you feel about the game in general, because I know it's problematic. You probably got some hot takes on it, but just more like, are you, if you're a fan, how you feeling about your team? Let us know.
If you're from the UK suffering through Brexit, what do you think?
And if you don't care about that, you probably do care about Spider-Man. So let us know what you think about that, that whole situation. Comments at thescopeshow.com. Call the voicemail line 612-21-SCOPE. That is 612-217-2673. Or reach out to us on Facebook or Twitter. Those links are on our website at thescopeshow.com. You want to support the show? Of course you do. Of course you do. It's the right thing you do. Creators do creative things. You want to support them. It's how our new modern economy works. Head on over to patreon.com/thescopeshow. You can sign up to be a patron.
Beep, boop, bop, boop.
A little as a dollar a month. Set a monthly cap. Cancel in time. But don't do that. We need your dollars to keep going, because Amazon could shut us down at any moment.
Amazon is putting the squeeze on us.
Scopeshow.com/Amazon.com. You can go there. You can click on a link. And it's an affiliate thing. We'll get a little kickback. It won't support us, though.
No.
Because we've been told you cannot support the show by shopping at Amazon.
But you can just go there. I bought some tennis wrap for my tennis racket, Jared.
Just go there and click on it.
Click on that button.
Or in the sidebar. It's there.
Don't do it through your phone, idiots. I mean, lovely listeners.
That's a gap. That's a gap in the tech, I think.
You've got to go through your computer, right?
I mean, the phone is a computer, technically.
True.
I just don't know if it works.
I feel trapped.
I don't know if it works.
Yeah,
mobile devices are weird. Do your best.
It automatically kicks you to the app, right? If you try to go through a browser.
I don't know. I wonder if it still sets the cookie or whatever that it came from you.
I don't know.
Whatever you're doing, however you're getting to the site, just know you're not supporting us.
You're not supporting us.
We can't offer any sort of guarantees or discounts. It is what it is. You're just clicking on a link. You're going to Amazon.
I wish you had a ding sound effect, because I would wink and then you'd go, ding.
I mean, all I can offer you is...
There we go. I winked and it went...
That's all I got. Back to you, Sean.
I'm winking. Do it again, Jared.
Hold on.
There we go.
The timing is important because everyone can see.
For us, it's important. Yeah. If you can hear my winks, they're very aggressive. Double wink. Back and forth. Wow. Well, we covered Spider-Man. We covered the NFL, as Jared said. And we hope you enjoyed it. Excuse me. I'm I did not. I'm
what
choking.
Was that?
I'm choking right now.
Where did that come from?
Clearing.
It's long. We are out of practice on this.
Dry oatmeal, Jared. That's what it was. All right, guys, let's wrap up episode 291. Thanks for listening. We'll be back next week with another episode. So until then, bye for now.
Ladies and gentlemen, we find ourselves once again at the end. I hope you've enjoyed our time together. I know I have. Fear not, Scope faithful. Days shall pass as if they were but a moment. And Jared, Adam, and Shane will return with another thrilling episode. Until then, send your comments to comments@thescopeshow.com or leave a voicemail message by dialing
612-21-SCOPE. That's 612-217-2673.
Thanks for listening, faithful fans. This is Tony Partington saying, tune in next time to another terrific edition of The Scope.